Hello, lads and lasses. Welcome to a damp but mild autumn morning here in the eastern townships of Quebec. The brilliant red colours of the maples have faded, most of the leaves have fallen, and we're in the yellow period now, which is a reminder that autumn is well advanced, winter is coming, and winter is a good time to go back to basics and work on our technical skills and improving our box playing so that we'll be ready when this ghastly COVID lockdown lifts and we can go back to festivals and clubs and pubs and enjoy music with others, that we'll be well prepared. So let's do some woodshedding, and I'll make a series of videos, I think, if I get around to it. Here's the first one, and I want to call it Back to Basics. Looking at the bellows and how to use your bellows efficiently to allow you to play reels fast, because I think when you first start playing the box and learning Irish reels, you're more concerned with the right hand and the fingering and getting all the notes in, and sometimes you're not paying much attention to your bellows, but really the bellows are key to being able to play fast, especially on our C sharp D system, which is a glorified melodeon, if you like. In many tunes there's not much cross rowing, so we need to tame those bellows and make it easy for ourselves to play quickly. So I'll show you a few exercises in this video that will hopefully help you, and if you practice these over the course of the autumn and the winter, you'll be in great shape for spring and summer. So here's the first exercise, and we'll take for this a phrase from a tune that I have a video tutorial up on. It's the march from Fingal. This is a very useful phrase to practice what I want to show you, and a kind of answering phase. Let's start with the first one, based on E minor. So all the accented notes are on the pull here. So we start with on beat, off beat, on beat, on beat, off beat. So those notes need to be given a little more accent than all the others that are on the push. All right. So just for this, use minimum bellows and let the bellows bounce back. You've pulled to accent a note. Just let it bounce back, feeling of bouncing back for the next note, which is less important. You can play it quite softly, use minimum bellows. And just practice that, and you'll find that if you give those accents, it becomes very easy to play the passage quickly. Much easier than if you were giving equal emphasis to the notes. And this is really the secret of playing fast on one of these boxes. All right, and then try it in the reverse direction. Here the accented notes are on the push, so let it bounce back. Sorry. Obviously don't over-exaggerate, don't exaggerate, like that, but as if it were part of the tune, using this bounce of the bellows, and this will make handling the bellows easier, it will make the tune flow better, and you'll get the right accents into your tune, a reel or any 4/4 tune, by doing that, by using that bounce. Okay, so that's the first exercise. And speed it up gradually. You'll need to pay attention, depending now, this is an old Hohner box with very supple, well-worn bellows, and getting this bounce is very easy. If you have a newer box, like I've got one down here, which I could show you, you'll have to use a little bit more effort. So you have to adjust to the box that you're playing, but use just enough pressure on the bounce to sound the note without giving it the same importance as the accented note. All right, so exercise one. Now, here's another exercise. This involves a passage of notes that we often get on the C-sharp D in tunes in E minor and G sometimes, where we go up the scale, missing out either C natural or C sharp, which means that whole passage of notes here is push, pull, push, pull all the time. And we need to make that easy for ourselves, and we need to make the accents flow nicely. And it's all the same thing. It actually comes, you can find an example of that passage in a tune called The Green Fields of Ross Bay, which goes something like. And we actually get an extra push-pull because the notes leading into it, the G, the F-sharp and the B, from here, push-pull. There you get a little slur. So, let's just practice that passage. And all the strong notes are on the push. And if you do that, using those accents, using the bounce of the bellows, then that passage, which when you first try it can seem very awkward, will become easy and you'll be able to make that reel flow beautifully. And if you want to stick in the extra two notes, so F sharp, push. Exercise number two. Exercise number three, what happens when your note pairs, accented and unaccented, are in the same bellows direction? Take this kind of common or garden phrase. You might find in any one of a half a dozen reels or small variants of this phrase. So we're push, pull, push. So for those notes, practice getting the accents. First note, slightly harder push. Obviously, don't exaggerate, don't make it. That would be very boring, but it's subtle. Or one going the other way. Little phrases for you to practice, all right? Now let's look a little bit more at this offbeat question by looking at a well-known tune, a very simple tune, called The Wind That Shakes the Barley. And we'll do a bog standard unornamented version. It's not the slinky West Clare version that you'll hear quite often. And it goes something like this. This is very, very plain. Sorry. So, in that version, again, two accented notes. This is on beat. We're going to cut it short. And the next note is off beat. So they both need to be accented. How much you accent the offbeat is up to you, but it needs to be stronger than all the other unimportant notes in between. So, and again, we have the bounce of the bellows. You've got another offbeat note here. Don't go mad with it, but. And then same thing in the opposite direction, the bounce is the other way. We're going to pull for the accented notes. Next phrase. On beat. Off beat. On beat.
offbeat. So, and that's the way you would make a very simple tune like that sound satisfying and enjoyable to a listener or a dancer without any ornamentation or any variations. Just yum ba di do do da da yum ba. Okay, so pay attention to those accents and those little notes in between and make it easy on yourself. Use minimum bellows, at least while you're practicing this. You can get louder later on. And tame the instrument. Get in touch with your inner melodeon player. All right, I hope you find these exercises useful, and I hope it improves your reels, the flow and the bounce and the accents in your reels. Thanks. Thanks for watching.